Hey everybody, and welcome to the next park playthrough. So hope everyone's doing well as we round off another year. So here we're jumping back over to the RCT base game scenario list and starting on Leafy Lake. So for those of you that are new to the channel, basically when I started this YouTube channel, I had already completed kind of the first 10 or 11 scenarios in the RCT base game list. So I've been wanting to go back and re-record a playthrough of these parks, just mainly for a bit of completeness sake, and also the fact that when I built these parks back a few years ago now, when I look back at them now, I feel like I didn't really fill out the space that well, and yeah, just the overall parks don't look, they didn't look that great for me, so I have been wanting to go back and redo them, so yeah, here we are now, and on to Leafy Lake. So Leafy Lake doesn't need that much of an introduction. It's a pretty achievable guest count of 500 guests by the end of October Year 3. You're given a nice big open space. Obviously it's got the big lake in the middle, a small area of land around the perimeter, and then a big nice open section kind of at the top end of the lake, and a pretty large loan size available, so yeah, money shouldn't be too much of a concern in this playthrough. Now, given that the space is quite a large one to work with, and I do want to kind of fill out all the available land, I'm going to go with a bit more of a spread out park than I might usually do, just so I'm not in a huge rush to fill out every single tile with scenery or rides and whatever else. So you could say it's going for a bit more of a classic RCT look. Now, speaking of a classic RCT look, I started off the park with a couple gentle rides in the Ferris wheel and the merry-go-round, which I think I've put basically in the same spot every single time I've played through Leafy Lake. They just feel right there, and it's probably because that's what I do every single time, and I can't think of anything else to do with those spaces. So yeah, just built them a couple tiles away from the path, put in a bit of light scenery in between, and also gave them a little bit of a fence around their perimeter. Trying my hand at a few different trees and shrubs this time around, those big silver birches and those real bushy looking green ones. I think they look really nice, and I feel like I haven't really used them in many of my parks recently. I feel like I've been sticking with a similar set of trees of late, so it's nice to try something new. After the flat rides were done, I jumped over to a steel mini coaster, which of course I tend to build in most of my parks. This one though, I did a bit more of a sprawling layout than I've been doing lately. But I really enjoyed the final look, and spreading it out was actually a lot of fun. Most of the ones I've been doing lately have been really compact, but it was nice to take up a bit of space with this one, and I quite like the end result. Again, I went for a few more different trees than I usually have been using of late, and it was a little bit tricky because there's actually quite a few tree styles in the park as it is, so it was kind of tricky just making sure that all the different types looked okay together. To make sure I had a ride with a bit more of a higher intensity, I put a twister or scrambled eggs kind of on the other side of the lake relative to the coaster. I upped the number of rotations that it did just to bump up that intensity rating ever so slightly, just to make it a more attractive ride to more of the guests. Then expanded the park further out that side with a miniature railway. Now, I was seriously considering putting a miniature railway that went around the perimeter of the whole lake as a bit of a transport ride, but yeah, I think it was going to make the park a little too cluttered overall, and it would have taken up space for the gentle and thrill rides around the perimeter, and given the fact that I would have needed to build path over or under the railway around the lake, it just, yeah, would have been too much of a hassle, I think. But as a compromise, I did do a little circuit just over kind of in the corner, and took up a nice chunk of that space over near the big wide open area just at the base of the hill there. I put in a little hill just at the first turnaround of the train there with a few little trees and bushes. Just thought it would be a nice little photo opportunity. I built up some path right next to the railway. And yeah, just filled out a bit of the space, just generally with some extra trees and shrubs around the place. And as you can kind of see, kind of what I was talking about before with the pathing, like even just those two crossings over the railway as it is, even just now, like were kind of painful to get in. Had to do a bit of landscaping around the place. So yeah, just doing that over, if I had put in a railway around the whole perimeter, there would have been a lot of that going on. So wanted to sort of limit that. But yeah, also put in a boat hire just across from the railway, across from the path there, because I feel like with Leafy Lake, you got to have at least one or two boat hires in there. Otherwise, the lake feels somewhat wasted. So yeah, got that in there. And then after I was done a bit more landscaping around the railway, then added in a car ride just in the little just in that little pocket of space in that railway loop. Decorated, I don't know, just went for a bit of a kind of classic RCT feel with a few nice little hedges and brick walls and some nice colourful trees and those little quarter-tile trees as well, ornamental trees, I think, which I, yeah, don't really use that much, and had a lot of fun just playing around with them, and, throwing around some shrubs down all over the place as well, so that was, yeah, that was a lot of fun. It was then time to get on with kind of the first, you know, really big coaster of the park, and I went for a looping coaster here. Now, for those of you that have been following the channel for a while, you'd probably be aware that I'm a pretty big fan of the YouTuber Silverette. He doesn't play RollerCoaster Tycoon all that much these days, but he's got some really good old playthroughs of some of the older base game scenarios in particular. And he's also got a couple kind of showcase videos of some of the scenarios that he's completed over the years. And his version of Leafy Lake had this really wonderful looping coaster in it. And I kind of shamelessly cloned that exact coaster for my version of Leafy Lake here. It was kind of one of those things when you see something, when you kind of envision that, you can't really get it out of your head, and like I liked that coaster so much, and I honestly just couldn't think of anything else to put there. Like once I saw that coaster, I'm just like, well, damn, I've got to put that in the park now too. So now it did start off as a clone anyway, at least the kind of first drop and then those few swooping turns into the double loops, that was pretty much identical. The last bit of the track deviated quite a bit from his layout, but then I did actually go back and add a few extra sweeping turns and a kind of a wraparound helix around the first drop, just before the double loop. Definitely draws the length out of the coaster a bit, but yeah, overall very happy with the changes. It was fun to get a little tunnel in the layout. So yeah, big thanks to Silverette, who's obviously been quite an inspiration for my videos. I'll also make sure to dig that video up that I was talking about where I first saw this particular layout, and I'll put that link in the description below so you can check it out for yourself. After I was done the changes to the layout, I threw in a few more of those silver birch trees around the place. I think they just go really well with the black track and the white supports. Did make a few changes to the pathing underneath the coaster, nothing too significant, but just wanted to make sure that the coaster supports didn't look too unrealistic, so yeah, I did a little bit of shuffling there. One particular section of pathing that I changed a lot was that bit just underneath the high-speed turnaround of the looping coaster. I wanted to get that all nice and symmetrical and, you know, build some sort of plaza, I guess, there. I think that would be a nice little bit of path interaction there. I know it's not the smartest to build a double wide paths in RCT1, but I usually find that as long as you limit them to, you know, two or three different sections of it, you can usually get away with it. I then kind of started putting in a little bit of pathing up until the kind of large section out the back, just to get something going and make sure I planned ahead for that. I then unlocked the swinging ship, which I thought, well, I should probably put that at least near the water, if not on the water. So that's what I did there, just near the turnaround of the looping coaster. And with that, I think that just about wraps up this video here. Anyway, I just wanted to say a huge thanks to all of you for your support throughout the year. All the kind comments that you leave me, I really do appreciate it, and it does give me the motivation to keep producing videos. And yeah, hope you continue to enjoy the stuff I produce. So yeah, thanks again. Anyway, I hope you all enjoy your holiday season. Take care, and we'll see you in the next video. Cheers. Bye.